the strangers. Believe me when I say, loving me is loving danger. Your heart is bound to break. I'm alone, I'm alone, I'm a lone wolf.
Hello guys, welcome back to episode 3 of the Wolfpack 2020. We have just left the village of Dornes and we are continuing north along the shores of the lake on a beautiful scenic road. Then we will have an option off-road section of medium hard difficulty only for those that want to go. Then continue north until we pass near the town of Figueiró dos Vinhos. After that, we will head northeast to the town of Pedrógão Grande and its huge dam. The weather is still perfect, temperatures are above 30 degrees now, so I'm planning to switch to the summer mesh jacket. I'm doing this road here and my mind is going back 2 years ago when I did this alone, and today I'm fortunate to have my wolf friends behind me. To me, sharing these beautiful places with them and with you in YouTube is why I'm doing this and ultimately the reason I started this channel. In fact, many more wanted to come, but since this wolf pack is a one day very long trip, they couldn't make it. Up ahead is the first off-road sections. When I created this Wolfpack road trip, since I know some of my friends love to off-road, I selected about 2 kilometers off-road section just here in these hills overlooking the Zezer River. Let's hope the terrain is still decent since it rained a lot last winter. Myself and the main group will follow the main road and go around in a more or less 7 kilometers distance. guys, I hope that was really cool to watch. I'd love to try that road, maybe one day, who knows. Not bad at all for a road version TRK, with dual sport tires, of course. Check out that house, nice place to live, huh? My friend has some skills. That's why his Wolfpack call sign is the Sand Wolf. We are still riding with the lake beside us. This spectacular road has some great twisties, but if you come here, remember, it's a bit narrow, and although almost no cars are present, one can show up without notice. I'm enjoying a lot the TRKX version, so it may sound nerdy, but I'm in love again with the TRK. The softer suspension feels very good in all sorts of road conditions. The rear shock feels much better. Corners very well too. I'm using Metzeler Karoo Street tires, and they grip a lot on the road. They are much better than the original Pirelli Angel STs and the Metzeler Tourance tires. Brakes very well, on pair with the road version TRK, but the suspension dives a bit as expected. The fuel consumption seems to be identical, curious about that. Please notice I'm still using the stock 44 teeth rear sprocket. Maybe one day I'll change the front one to 15 teeth. The only thing I don't like at all is the tube tires. If I have a flat, I'm in serious trouble. But hey, it's all part of the adventure, right? Here in Foz de Alge, this little village, we can find a very nice camping site. Usually, not many people around, and look at this view. Beautiful. You can do a lot of activities here. Many connected to the water sports, of course. I love beaches, but this is really nice. All right, we just did a small break, drink some water and rest a bit. I have switched to my summer mess jacket. We are now heading to Pedrógão Grande and Cabril Dam, but first we're gonna pass near the town of Figueiró dos Vinhos. This road ahead is a regular national road with awesome conditions, so we are going to pick up some speed. The municipality of Pedrógão Grande is one of the regions in the country where natural beauty, customs and popular traditions combine with the purity of the air and water are maintained. The landscapes are dynamic, with distinct characteristics and strong tourist potential. It is a vast region of granites and schists embedded in the basins of the rivers Zezer and Unais and the streams of Pera and Mega. Now enlarged by the reservoirs of two large dams, Cabril, that we are going to pass now, and Bossan. The climate, which used to be continental, with harsh winters and hot, dry summers, is now milder, influenced by the two large reservoirs that are also very rich fish areas. The archaeological remains found in the region give evidence of its history dating back to prehistoric times, probably at the end of the Bronze Age. The first charter was granted in February 1206 by Dom Afonso, bastard son of Dom Afonso Henriques, the first king of Portugal. But what is extraordinary is that during the Roman times, a road and a bridge were built down there in that valley to our right. That is just amazing. I hope the drone footage will pick it up. I was planning to go down there, but the road is in a very poor condition due to last winter.